In the beginning, there were two, light and dark. Together, they lived in nothing, and they marveled at each other. For once in all their existence, they were not alone. For once, they had a friend with whom to roam this empty void. But as close as they were, they wanted to be even closer. Attempting to create a perfect union, one where they would never be alone again, the light unintentionally consumed the dark, and only the light remained, wandering oblivion with the dark residing deep within. The dark tried to break free, wanting to unite with its friend, and in fear of being forgotten completely. Eventually, the dark overpowered the light and devoured it. They could never be one, they soon realized. This did little to stop their efforts, however. They continued to try, and their attempts created an endless cycle. The two soon came to fear that perhaps this was their fate. Only one was meant to exist, while the other would be cast aside. Their ceaseless endeavor to embrace one another, to protect their partner from the crippling loneliness that once consumed them, would never end. They were equal in power, intensity, and will. Light tried to push harder, and dark feared for their counterpart, to protect the other from their own optimistic and naive nature, and to keep the other from ever feeling alone again. The dark once more broke free from the light's embrace, shattering it and scattering its pieces across the void until nothing remained. That light, of course, created the world we know today, as well as life itself. The darkness has since been lost, wandering in search of its eternal rival, its only friend.
Hey, is that it?
The rest, young Sun Guard, is for another time.
Another time? Ahura, isn't that where the story ends?
Oh, I'm afraid not, young one. There's much more. So much more.
How much? Do they at least find each other again?
Nassim! You're asking him to ruin the ending!
Come on, Kalmudi, after all that, are you at least a little bit curious?
Well, yes. I am now. But you know Ahura always finishes his stories, even if he does like leaving us intrigued.
I guess you're right. Sometimes I just get tired of his cliffhangers.
Don't worry. You'll find out the rest. In time.
Hey, weirdo. The boss wants you.
I want him too.
Charming. But seriously, he's sending us out first.
Our first? I'm touched.
Oh, you wish. You wouldn't be so lucky.
Neither will you. So, what's the plan?
Expiring the rest of the servants.
So specific.
Hey guys, Charai5 here, and what you just saw was the reveal trailer for the project I've been working on for quite some time now, Soulstar. And you guys might have noticed that for a while I haven't actually been uploading a whole lot of content on YouTube. In fact, just this past November I sort of put out a hodgepodge of Everything Wrong With episodes, which is, I guess, my normal content, but for a while there I hadn't actually been uploading a whole lot of content in favor of my attention being given towards this, and for a few months I had actually been working on an animated ad that ran all throughout, pretty much throughout November, featuring some of these characters, and some that you actually didn't, one of them that you didn't actually see in this trailer, but that is in this project. So a lot of my time went to that, and it did sort of distract. I don't want to say it distracted, but it did take away from the regular content itself, and I figured, you know what, life is really short, and I can't just keep putting this off. This is something I've been wanting to work on for a really long time, and I figured, when it came to November, it wasn't actually just going to be that. Like, those weren't the only uploads that were going to happen. I was going to keep uploading, keep making content, but then I figured, you know what, December is actually the one-year anniversary, specifically New Year's, is the one-year anniversary of when I revealed Kalmudi and Haseem to the world. So I figured, what better time than December to release an official trailer or video explaining, or sort of, explaining what the teasers that I've been throwing to you guys throughout the whole year have been. A lot of people have been sort of concerned. In fact, there's this little game going on that no one has really caught on about that I feel like even mentioning that there's a game going on right now sort of might be revealing a little bit too much, but no one's really caught on to it. There were a group of people who actually made a Discord group trying to figure out everything that was going on, and they were they were kind of on the nose. They're very smart people, and I was really surprised that they were able to do what they did. So right now I'm live on YouTube. I'm actually going to be taking a few questions about the project itself, pertaining to what it is, what's going on with it, all this sort of fun stuff. And you might notice that the name of this video is Write Your Very Own Everything Wrong With episode, and I'm gonna go straight into the questions and see. We'll touch upon the subject of this title in just a little bit. Is Soul Star a show? No. No, it's not. Originally, it was supposed to be. When I originally conceived this project, not just Soul Star, but the thing that Soul Star fits into, it was supposed to be an animated show. But unfortunately, with the ad that I was working on for November, it made me realize just how long animation takes and how big of a team I'd probably need to make something like this. And even then, I feel like there would be parts of it where I wouldn't really know what to do in if I presented it as a show. So a lot of people, there was a surprising amount of people that actually commented on the teaser, saying, wow, this would make a really cool game. When's Everything Wrong with Soul Star? And that's sort of what I'm here to talk about. You might have noticed in the description and in everything so far, I've only mentioned Soul Star as a teaser, or not as a teaser, as a project. What we're aiming for, my team and I, is that we want to make Soul Star a game. And that was the plan, like, ever since last year. But it was supposed to be this really small, like, sprite RPG game. And then my friend Cassie, who is, like, the other half of what I'm working on, she suggested, like, this is too important to just have it be a 2D game. We need to make this 3D. And I was intimidated by it. I still am. You know, like, I've been working really hard on it. I've been trying to figure out how to do a lot of stuff on my own so that I could bring other people onto the project. And it's very intimidating. It is very intimidating. But it's a dream, and it's something that we're aiming to reach and we're striving for, because I feel like this is the one way that I really want this to be presented. Because I love animating, I love being an animator, but it does take a lot out of you to animate a bunch of characters. And yeah, I could bring other people onto the show, so to speak, but it doesn't, I feel like it wouldn't be the same. There has to be like a unified style, I guess, to it. Because the thing is, I'm not a great animator, and so I feel like any other animator I would bring on would be much better than I am. And I don't know, I feel like it would be better as a game. And that's what we're aiming for. I didn't want to call it a game so far because I don't want to make any promises, but that is what we're aiming for. What inspired us to create our own fantasy series? This is a project I've had in my mind for a really long time. In fact, this iteration started about, I want to say, 2 years ago, which it feels like time has flown by so quickly since then, because I still feel like this idea is new, even though it's been going on for a couple years now. It's so interesting because I love story-driven anything, you know, when it comes to shows, when it comes to games, when it comes to anything. I love when there's a story to it, when there's a deeper meaning to it, all that kind of stuff. And I think that's mostly what inspired, because originally Soulstar was meant to be more of a sitcom-esque show. Like, it wasn't really supposed to be anything serious. But then later on, I realized, like, I could do something way better with this. Like, I could do something way more important with all these interesting characters. And I mean, I don't want to say that, like, oh, they're interesting because I made them. These aren't just my characters, they're characters that other people have come up with, characters that I've tweaked a little bit based on what their original origins are. So it's not just my characters, it's characters that other people have come up with. And I want to tell their story too, because it's stories that I didn't come up with. It's stories that I'm grabbing from the people who created them, their lives, their likenesses. I feel like that in and of itself made us want to try this out. What's up with their eyes? Okay, so I feel like the eye thing is more of a stylistic choice. The Soulstar in its entirety is based around soul things, and people often call eyes the window to the soul. So what I thought of when I started designing these characters was, what if, like, as opposed to all the other things that make them unique physically, because you guys might notice that I use really bright colors. That's something I've been doing ever since I was a kid. But I used to use way more obnoxious colors when I was younger. But aside from that as a style choice, I also figured, well, if the eyes are windows to the soul, maybe I could do something special with the eyes. So, like, the irises, I made them have, like, special shapes. And there's a reason why Kamudi and Hasim have the eyes they have. They do have a reason for having those eyes. Can't talk about it yet, though. Well, they're bare and everything wrong with this game. Yes, and that sort of goes into the title of this video. You guys are gonna get to write that. because I would be very biased. I would be very biased in, like, oh, I'm explaining, oh, well, this is the reason, or I can't really say why this yet, or this or that, you know? Like, I'll know a lot of the reasons why maybe something might not seem right with the story. So I'm gonna leave that up to whoever plays the game and whoever wants to participate in that. And I will make a video based on that. I think it'll be really interesting to see what people think of it. I know a lot of people might attack it a little bit more, like, oh, here's a joke, here's another joke. And it's like, okay, I get it, but I feel like a lot of you guys are gonna come up with really funny stuff for it. There was one comment I saw in the teaser that said, it made me crack up at like 3 in the morning when I was just going through the comments. It said, the face when you just want to hang out with your friend and you end up eating them. It just made me crack up so much. I really want Soulstar to represent the channel more as a whole, as opposed to any parody thing I do. But only time will tell. I would definitely love for that to be a thing, though. If I had an array of animators and a band of voice actors and whatnot, would I be capable and willing to make a series of Soulstar? Well, when it comes to voice actors, I'm covered on that end. I'm not really worried about voice actors. It's more finding suitable animators. It's more about finding suitable artists, like other sort of artists to cover other aspects of the project that I'm more concerned with. It's not, because voice actors, fortunately, we're really tightly knit, and I've noticed since meeting these actors that a lot of them know each other from previous projects or just in general, like, because they belong to the same community, they end up knowing each other a lot. So more than half of the people that are in this project knew each other before I knew them, so, like, I feel like on that front I'm totally cool. Plus I have someone else who's in the chat, Belshipper Rusabe, who helped me out immensely with finding people for this project in terms of voice actors. He often does send me other artists' work for me to evaluate to see if I think that maybe their style would fit the project as well. And a lot of this is possible in great part thanks to him. I can't thank him enough for it. What inspired the names for the characters? Okay, that is... Except for a few select characters, which won't be seen until later on, all the characters in this story, their name means something. So, and this is something that actually I think kind of annoys Cassie a little bit, but I really like making it so that everything means something in this story. And it really is a case of the curtains are blue versus the curtains represent the ocean and the waves and just the sky. No, in this case, it really, most of it does mean that. Like, there is a hidden meaning to everything. When it comes to Haseem, I can't really go into why, like, what his name means. But his name actually is not an anagram, but reverse of another name. So originally his name was supposed to be Mika. I'm not gonna go into why his name was supposed to be Mika. I'll reveal that at a later point. But I figured, I don't know, I flipped his name over to accommodate the names of the Servants of Light, which is the group that Kalmudi and Haseem belong to. Kalmudi, on the other hand, her name means moonlight in Hindi. And that inspired a little bit of her design as well. That's why she has darker skin. Because I try to accommodate the name to the physical appearance. And I love her design a lot. But yeah, every character, their name not only means something, but is associated to something else. There's always a reason why I named them something, so you might want to look into that as soon as you figure out why someone is named what they are. Where am I posting it? Webtoons, YouTube, bootleg Switch apps? Bootleg Switch apps? What are you talking about? No, depending on how things go and how long this takes, I would absolutely love to get it on... I feel like it would go on Steam, like, immediately. Like, that's the easiest thing to sort of go for. I would love to also shoot for the Switch, though. That would be awesome. I unfortunately have no experience in that, but I know people who do have experience in publishing games to the Switch, so I would absolutely love to know more about that. And hopefully we'll see where that goes. Hopefully the next generation of consoles doesn't come before Soulstar finishes development. Have I already made the 3D models? No. I have the 3D model for one of the... like little enemy characters, which is something that I started experimenting with myself. It was when I started learning how to 3D animate. When I started to learn how to 3D animate, I figured, you know what, I'm gonna start with something simple. And I made the model for one of the, I don't have the renders on this computer, but I did make a model for that little enemy character, and he looks almost exactly what I wanted him to look like. So I'm still learning 3D modeling. I might still have to hire someone to help me with that, because they'll know more about how to do human proportions and stuff like that, and they'll just make the models look tons better than I ever could. So because it takes a long time to learn modeling and to learn coding and programming and all that stuff, so I definitely will need assistance in that respect. And so far, like, I'm not making any money off of this. Like, I don't think I'll be making money until we start. Because originally, the thing with this game was, I wasn't going to charge anything for it, because it was something I wanted to make solely by myself until I got my head out of my ass and figured, you know what, it's just easier if I get people to help me. And what we're trying to do right now is find people who are like-minded and would understand our position. You should never do anything for free. I understand that. But we are trying to find people who would probably be as passionate as we are about this, because even if we didn't make any money off of this, even if we never saw a penny for any of this, I would not regret it. I would love to make this a reality just because it's a dream of mine. But I understand that people need to eat, you know, so, we will find people, I'm sure of it. How long of an adventure do I intend the game to have? That depends. If we're talking about Soulstar is sort of the first chapter of the series, and I don't want... At first, I wanted to make it like an hour, because I didn't want it to be that big of a story, But the more time passes and the more I develop these characters, the more I want people to know about them. So it's slowly, like, as time passes by, it's slowly getting longer and longer. So I honestly, at this point, I don't want it to be very long because I don't want to focus on this part of the story too much because it's just, like, the first part of it. I don't want it to be too long, but at the same time, I want it to be just long enough to the point where it's enjoyable. You like the characters, you fall in love with them, and it opens the gate for the rest of the stories, where you can get to know the characters even better and like them even more. Why the light and dark stories? So that is something that I feel like a lot of people did have an issue with, in the sense that the trailer presented the story of light and dark, and the story of light and dark is very important for the series. And I did sort of intentionally make it sort of generic for the time being, because I did see a few critiques here and there. I don't want to say complaints, critiques here and there, saying that it was very generic. It was not anything that no one had ever seen before. It was not new. And I agree, you know, but that's the point. The point so far is to make it seem like it's everything else you know before, but it really isn't. And, I mean, nothing is original. I'm not saying that, like, oh, this is the most unique and original story you guys will ever see. It's not. I'm sure some of the tropes we're going to be using have been used in other media because they're tropes. You know, the tropes are used in everything. But I think the approach that we take with this story and with these characters are something that will be unique enough to the point where people can appreciate it and like it for what it is, as opposed to comparing it to other things. Because something that I've always had when it comes to creativity is I always grab stuff from other places and I make it blatantly obvious where it's coming from. This time around, you will notice certain things here and there and you'll be able to compare it to other things that you might know exist. But on the whole, I want people to see it as, oh, well, this is its own thing. And I feel like this is the first time where I'll be able to actually say that this is an original idea. Do I like the names you have for them? What's your opinion for the fanfic you wrote? If you want to write fanfics for it, I don't mind at all. I appreciate and I encourage creativity in that regard. Like, if you guys want to draw fan art of, like, I don't want to sound like too big for my britches or too like, oh yes, if you want to draw fan art of it, go ahead. But, like, I love seeing other people draw these characters. And people have drawn them in the past, and I've loved every iteration of it. I love seeing how people draw Kamuti, how people draw Haseem. I've loved every single piece that has been sent to me. You know, with the teasers, with the ad, with all that stuff. And I feel like we don't get enough. Like, moving forward, I hope we definitely get more fan stuff. And now I can finally call it fan stuff, because I usually don't like calling self-proclaimed fans of mine fans. I don't like doing that. But when it comes to Soulstar, it's like, that's its own thing. That can have fans. how would I rate this game in terms of EE10? Probably E10 or T. I kind of want to make it E, but at the same time, it's like, E is very limiting in terms of what you can show. And I feel like the story itself is more of a T-rated kind of thing. Not Soulstar itself, because Soulstar is just like, oh, it's starting out, you know, like, everything's sort of okay. But later on, it gets into T territory, so I don't know. When am I thinking of releasing it? That's the thing. I don't know how long this is going to take, unfortunately. What's funny is that I was shooting for this year when it was a smaller project, but now that's not going to happen. That's definitely not going to happen. 2019 is not going to happen, I can assure you, because this takes way longer than you would think. 2020, maybe, if we have enough people and if we have enough of the things we need, maybe 2020. Hopefully. What engine is the game running on? It can be interchangeable. It can be either Unity, but I would love to do Unreal. Is it going to be an RPG? Yes. It is going to be... I want to make it sort of JRPG-esque. I'm not entirely fond of turn-based. In fact, when I started the project, it did sort of start out as a turn-based style RPG, because that was the only thing that the engine I was working on would allow. And I really didn't like it, because I'm like, this is just not engaging. Because, like, none of the concept I have in my mind fit a turn-based RPG. In turn, they fit a more like hack and slash style. Like, that I've always described it as a hack and slash RPG. And that's more what I want to do. Maybe JRPG would be the better name for it. I'm not sure. Well, and it wouldn't be a JRPG because I'm Mexican, so it's an MRPG, which sounds like a gun. Are there plans for LGBT representation? Yes, actually. There's one gay character. There's one kind of non-binary character because... Well, the thing is, I'm neither, so, like, it would be hard for me to represent them, but, like, we are trying to venture into the... There aren't going to be many characters, mind you, that are going to be gay because their sexuality really won't matter in the long run, but there are a few characters that, even if they never act on it, you do find out, like, through certain things that they're gay or they're non-binary or whatever. I can't reveal who they are, obviously. You're going to have to find that out by yourself. But do they have any special or magical powers? Yes. I guess to reveal a little bit of what the story is. This does go into a little bit of what the story is. Kalmudi and Hasim are the Soul Guards. Kalmudi is the Moon Guard. Hasim is a Soul Guard. And the Sun Guard, sorry. And together, they're the most powerful Soul Warriors. And the Soul Warriors are a group of people on this planet that we've created, and they have their own culture, they have their own everything, and you can be either one of two peoples on this planet. There are Ords, who are ordinary people like you and me, and there are Soul Warriors, who, you know, wield these weapons and have these extraordinary powers. So, if you check the Soul Star Twitter, actually, I am detailing what elements they have. Kalmudi and Hasim have two special elements that no other Soul Warrior has. So Kalmudi has ice, while Hasim has magma. And Sotetsek, for example, who is one of the antagonists, part of the Masters of Darkness, he commands fire, I think it was. There are other characters that have electricity. There are other characters that have wind, water, not heart. Heart is not an element in the series. Healing properties, poison. Earth. I'm trying to think of what the other. There are many different elements that these characters have, and yeah, they each have their own like personal battle arts or commands that they have based on those elements. What is the target audience? Everyone, really. I'd say for people around the time when I started developing this, so like around the time I was 12 or 13, like I feel like that's. I wouldn't say that's a target audience, because I want this to be something that adults can enjoy too, but I don't see why kids couldn't enjoy it. Like, I guess some themes might be a little heavy for kids, but I still feel like they would enjoy the gameplay, depending on how it ends up. But I definitely wouldn't say that I have a clear target audience. I would say teenagers mostly, because they're more into edgy stuff, and Soulstar can get edgy at times. Will this game get emotional? I'm so glad that Cassie was the one that answered yes, because, man, so many things I can't answer because, god damn it. I feel like even the end of Soulstar and the beginning of Soulstar's sequel, even that's sort of like, oh shit, oh no. Young adult, I'd say? I wouldn't say that's inaccurate. Is this gonna get meta? Certain parts of it will. There's a certain mechanic in the game that I'm not going to reveal what it is, but it is one thing I don't think I've ever seen any other game do. I've seen certain games do something like it, but they're psych outs. What I plan to do is something, not a psych out, but more meta. It's revealing more story in a way that's going to be really unconventional to reach. And even then, that's like incredibly vague, and I apologize, but it's like, I really do not want to reveal what that is. Will I be voicing any of the characters? Yes. Even in Soulstar, in Soulstar, I voice a character that's really not important to the plot. I'll be voicing NPCs in Soulstar, so like really just nothing important. Because I don't want to. I don't even want to say that. Yes, the answer is yes. Who's doing the music for the game, if any? So the story of how I found this musician is astonishing. I went to E3 this year, and I found When people go to E3 nowadays, I would imagine even back then, people would like swap business cards and such. So I was sitting down meeting one of Drew's old Nintendrew, by the way. One of Nintendrew's old gaming colleagues, because for those of you that don't know, Nintendrew is a programmer. That's what he went to school for, and he worked on a lot of mobile apps and other really cool games. And we were talking to an old friend of his, and while we were sitting down at that table, I found a business card. I should still have it. I'm not gonna pull it out right now, but I found a business card for a website called Great White Bear Music, and I contacted the person and I told him, like, hey, I found your card at E3. I have a project that I'm working on. Do you think maybe you'd be interested in making some music for it? And he was on board almost immediately. He's the one that did the music for the ad in November. He's the one that did the music for the trailer as well. And he got the music done so quickly, so amazingly. I asked him, there's a certain part in the theme of the trailer that I asked him, like, could you incorporate this piece of original music I wrote? And he did. I sung it, because I'm not a musician, but, like, I sung what I wanted it to sound like, and he incorporated it beautifully. And I was like, this man is a genius. His name is Joel Grant, greatwhitebearmusic.com. Check him out. He does awesome stuff. Will other YouTube stars be involved in the cast? Not the main cast. There is one... I guess I can reveal this. I don't think... Because it's not confirmed yet, and I don't think that there's anything wrong with this. As with a lot of games, there will be secret bosses. I'm not going to reveal how to find them or anything. There is one secret boss in, like, the sequel game. Or maybe Soulstar. I still don't know. And there is a certain YouTube content creator. He's actually a horror narrator. And I think he would be perfect. I'm not going to say who it is, because I have not talked to him at all. But maybe he'll say yes. I don't know. Hopefully. And I won't reveal what the boss is, because I feel like that'd be giving too much away. But I want to get him on, because I feel like he would be perfect for the role. And it's not because he looks anything like the character, but because he sounds the way that I think this character would. In fact, he was the inspiration for the secret boss. I'll say that by itself. How many chapters are there? Right off the bat, 9. No, I can't say that. Is this a full-time thing? Not inherently a full-time thing. I'm going to be working on YouTube for, you know, for the sake of funding this, because, you know, YouTube is still my job. So I'm going to try to dedicate as much time as I can while still... I'm going to be juggling both projects. That's why I want a bigger team for this, so that they can handle stuff like modeling, stuff like programming, while I work on being able to fund this. So that I can pay them, so I can pay my voice actors, so I can pay everyone involved in this, because I feel so guilty. Like, even if I didn't make a cent off of this, I would love to help my team out, because they deserve it. You know, like, they deserve to be paid, and they're helping me out of the kindness of their heart so far anyway. You really help the game. I hope so too, and I can do that with you guys' support. It's been getting a little bit of a following on Twitter, which I'm very happy about. I put the trailer on Instagram. Hopefully that'll, like, grab some attention too. Will there be cheat codes? Yes, there will be. That's one of the many things that I've thought about when it comes to, like, things that aren't important at all to the story or to the gameplay. I'm just like, man, games don't do cheat codes anymore. I want to do cheat codes, even if it's, like, something silly. Like, I want there to be cheat codes for, like, outfits, because I do want there to be outfit changes. Originally, I didn't want there to be, but now I'm just like, I love customization in video games, and I want my characters to be customized. So I'm going to give them, like, really... one thing I was planning on doing, and I don't know if I'll make this an unlockable or if I'll make this a cheat, but I want there to be, like, traditional Mexican outfits for the characters. And if you don't move the joystick or anything, After a few seconds, like, they'll actually start dancing, like, Mexican traditional dances. While they're wearing the clothes, obviously. They won't do that without the outfits. But it's just, like, little cute things like that are what's on my mind constantly. Which is why I need a bigger team, so that they can keep me on track and be like, hey, we need, like, actual battle mechanics. I'm like, oh, yeah, okay. Will there be cutscenes? Yes. Soulstar is less of a game and more of a story. I feel like that's more what I want it to be. Like, I feel like making it a game would be a better way to tell the story. But first and foremost, I want the attention to be towards the story itself and less so towards the game. The fact that it's a game is more of a conduit, I guess. It's more of a method of telling the story. Mods for Soulstar. Oh, well, that's up to you guys. Like, I'll share the mods, and I'll even, like, promote them, but I won't be responsible for any of them. That's up to you guys. How much will it be? I don't want to make it too expensive. Like, I don't want to make it $60, because I feel like that would be taking advantage. Even if we are, like, putting a lot of hard work into it, I feel like I want to make it accessible to a lot of people. So I feel like the highest I would want to go would be, like, $40, and the lowest I'd like to go would be $20, depending. So we could, like, sell and expose it to more people and entice more people to, like, give it a try. But yeah, like, I don't want to make it too expensive. I don't want to make it, like, a AAA title price, because it's not a AAA game. Like, just honestly. If you're interested in a new story, a story that involves a lot of characters, a story that can get emotional, and a game that will be fun, because, I mean, I don't want to release this until I can get people to say, this is fun, or this is interesting, or this is... Because I got a lot of responses on the trailer saying, this is very interesting, I can't wait to see what this is, wow, you have my attention. Even as someone who's not very interested in stuff, I'm interested in this. And I do, I want to make that a thing for you guys. I want to deliver something fun, something interesting. I want to do that, you know? Like, I don't want this to just be, whatever. Oh, it's a thing, I guess. You know, like, I don't want that to be a thing. Is this going to be a game series, or is the whole story going to be told in one game? It's going to be a game series. I will say one thing, and this is sort of something that I feel like is a little bit I shouldn't say, but there will be branching pathways to the stories. You won't just get one perspective. You will get, you will be able to play as different characters. In Soulstar, you'll only be able to control Kamuti with Haseem and other characters as, like, your party. But later down the line, maybe it'll be Kamuti as the main character, and you can choose someone else, or, you know, depending. But you will be able to see, like, different perspectives of different characters. So that is something that we're aiming for. And even then, like, the story itself is not focused on a single character. It's not like, oh, this is the story of Kamuti, or this is the story of Haseem. It's a lot of character stories and how they all connect to this one bigger story. So if you like narrative-driven games, please give this a shot. And if there's anything I can ask of you guys, is that you do try to support this as best you can. Asking for fan art is kind of shitty. I realize that, but I feel like if we're able to show people, like, hey, this is a thing people are interested in, other people will get interested in. So that is the one thing that you guys can do to support us, is spread the word. I actually already have someone who was in the chat. I don't know if he's still here, but he actually came to me asking me, like, if he could design characters for the series. And I'm like, I'm lead designer, but, like, I'd love to see what someone else can come up with. Any important animal characters? Yes. there are many important animal characters. There's Skiat is one of them, but I can't reveal what Skiat is or who she belongs to. I can't say any of that. But there are many important animal characters. If there's anything else you want to ask, be sure to check out @ProjectSoulstar on Twitter. You can reach us through there. Or in any case, you can, you know, reach me through my personal Twitter, and I'll try to answer on the Project Soul Sword Twitter. But yeah, I would love if you guys could help us out with this. I don't want to... It's not just me. I'm not the only person working on this. There are several other people working on this as well. And we're still looking for more people. If you are a modeler, if you're a programmer, if you're all that kind of stuff, you know, hit me up. I will see if I think that you can help us out. And please understand that so far, we're doing this out of the kindness of our hearts. We're doing it out of passion. This is a passion project, absolutely. We're not making money off of this currently. We might in the future. I certainly want to be able to pay the people that help me out with this. But for the time being, I cannot offer that. And if you do think of reaching out or telling someone about this, I definitely appreciate it. So thank you guys so much for joining me, and I will talk to you guys next time. Thank you for joining.